from who's a Kias scholar and at Osaka University. So I've known Ogiso for about 25 years since he was a graduate student with Kawamata. His title is, as you can see, Birational Geometry from Complex Dynamics.
Thank you very much for introduction and thank you very much for invitation. And my talk today is very concerned very complete program on this problem. Find many examples of projective or scalar manifold of dimension L admitting interesting birational automorphism of infinite order. Later, primitive bilateral automorphism of positive entropy. And here, and in this program, if dimension is less than 1, then only a manifold which has infinite order automorphism is P1 and one-dimensional complex torus, and all automorphism are well understood. So we assume dimension is greater than or equal to 2. And this kind of automorphism is a quite natural object and long history, but from the viewpoint of complex dynamics started by Kanta and McMurrin around this century, so support is relatively new. And I'll explain primitive and positive entropy later, but first I explain primitive one. And primitive automorphism is, in some sense, automorphism which does not come from lower dimensional pieces. So, in other words, in primitive means manifold we are interested in admit to L equivariant rational dominant maps over positive dimensional bases and lower than original manifold dimensions. And so, how about basic manifolds? As most basic projective manifold is probably PL, and automorphism of PL is PGLL plus 1C, and mostly order infinite. But because PL is Picard number 1, so does not admit any non-trivial vibration, but you can easily construct many, many dominant rational vibrations. And in fact, PL has no primitive bilateral automorphisms. In this sense, PL itself is not so interested in our themas. Reason is almost clear. If you have some automorphism, then there is some fixed point, and one can just blow up that fixed point to get to equivariant morphism, which is in terms of PL rational vibration, equivariant rational vibrations. And next, let us consider smooth quintic threefold. This is a Calabi-Yau threefold and appear in many contexts. But in this case, worsely, birational automorphism and automorphism is both finite. This is because M is minimal and Picard number is 1. And minimality implies that all birational automorphism is pseudo automorphism. In other words, isomorphic in codimension 1. But nevertheless, in this talk, rational manifold and Calabi-Yau manifold are the main topics. And rational manifold is everyone know. Everything is over C. This does not matter. Manifold birational to projective space. And Calabi-Yau manifold is a simply connected projective manifold, which has no global holomorphic K-form until dimension, but admit everywhere global holomorphic L-form of dimension. And maybe partly hyperkala manifold and complex torus appear in this talk. And why these are target? This is explained by the following nice observation by De Zizan. let them be a projective manifold of dimension L. And assume minimal model program works in dimension L. This means after a divisorial contractions and flow, we reach either minimal model or a modified space. And we assume both are exclusive. Then, manifold with primitive birational automorphism of infinite order is necessarily birational to three kinds of manifold. Rationally connected manifold, this is explained by Professor Korazdo, and most basic ones should be rational manifold, and so-called Calabian variety in the sense of minimal model theory, and Calabian manifold and projective hyperkähler manifold is very basic examples of second class, and last class is Abelian variety. And minimal model theory works well by Professor Kawamata, Miyaoka, Professor Miyaoka, Professor Mori, Professor Lee, and others. And so this theorem is unconditional. And his idea is actually very simple, and consider any map which is preserved under birational automorphisms. For example, typically pluricanonical map is such a map. So from here we can conclude quaternary dimension is either zero or minus infinity already. Then if quaternary dimension is zero, then next we consider Albanese map. Then very fundamental theorem by Professor Kawamata, Albanese map is surjective with connected fiber. This already implies these two. And so remaining case is kappa is minus infinity case. But in this case, modified relation is very useful too. And actually, this shows that under the assumption it is uniruled. But modified relation itself is not canonical. There are many choices of extremal rays. But instead of it, but we use it, considering much more rational connected fibration, we conclude that if kappa is minus infinity, then necessarily rationally connected. So, first three examples naturally appear. Then, what kind of automorphism is primitive and infinite order? Maybe this is a simplest example. Considering Abelian surface and take very general point, and consider a translation by very general point. Then each orbit is topologically dense in A, and when this automorphism is primitive. And answer is if and only if A is a simple Abelian surface. The reason is because only if part is only interest. And actually, otherwise, because of the simpleness, we have equivalent rational map, but base space is necessarily P1. Then, induced action on P1 always has fixed point, and considering its fiber and its very general point, then iterate of this remain in fiber and contradiction. So this is one example, but maybe not so interesting because automorphism is not so drastically changed things. And positivity of topological entropy is one invariant which excludes this kind of example. And let me explain briefly what is topological entropy. And so considering let X be a compact metric space and F is a continuous surjective self map of X. And so, in order to explain feeling, let's assume that epsilon is a very small number such that we can distinguish two points in X by I if distance is greater than or equal to epsilon. Then, because X is compact, we can recognize X as a finite remaining points, so something very. But if we cannot distinguish the point, but after operating f, if by chance distance become bigger than or equal to epsilon, then we can distinguish these two points after performing f. And topological entropy is a kind of measure of logarithmic growth of this quantity. How many points does x look like by eyes after performing iteration of given morphisms? And so this is larger and larger means some complexity of the action of this f. And precise definition is just formally like this. Here, this number is number of how many points x looks like after n minus 1's iterate with respect to e. So this number is logarithmic growth of the point increasing. And this is mathematics, so we exclude ambiguity of epsilon by taking limit. This is a definition of topological entropy and quite far from algebraic geometry in the origin. And because x is compact, so any continuous map is uniformly continuous, so topological entropy does not depend on metric, so really topological. And if it is isometry of some metric, then because this number does not change at all, so topological entropy must be zero. So for example, translation of the torus can be excluded if we assume topological entropy positive. And also, if topological entropy is positive, then order must be necessarily infinite. So this is much stronger than order is infinity. And my example is like this. Let us consider a product abelian surface and f is an automorphism given by this matrix, naturally given by this matrix. Then one can compute topological entropy like this. And one reason is the eigenvalue of n alpha beta satisfies this. So we can consider eigenvector direction of alpha and eigenvector direction of beta. Then after iteration of f, eigenvector direction of alpha goes to alpha times, so larger and larger, but beta direction is smaller and smaller. So one can distinguish only alpha directions. So this gives approximately after n minus i's iterate, we can approximately recognize this kind of numbers. Then taking a log and limit, we can obtain these numbers. And our n turn out to be primitive, I'll explain later, coming back later. And another important thing is that entropy computed here is natural logarithm of spectral radius of this quantity. This is quite homological and close to algebraic geometry. So first definition is quite combinatorial, but this is more algebraic geometry. And this is not accidental. This is a famous, important fundamental theorem by Gromov Yomi. So let M eta compact scalar manifold of dimension L, and F is a surjective holomorphic map. Here eta is a fixed scalar hole. Then Gromov-Yomin theorem says that topological entropy can be computed by algebraic geometric method. So let me explain what these values. Here RPF is a spectral radius of the natural action of F on PP component, PP Hodge component, and RF is a spectral radius of the action of total homology, and this is only even part. So this part is purely one can compute in several ways, and Later, it's very important that the peace dynamical degree. Peace dynamical degree is again a kind of limit, and the limit is taken by this value with once taking this. And the important point is that this part is entirely cohomological, even if we write this as integral. But this part is also analytic nature. And the theorem says that all of these values are equal. This is very surprising. And, and actually, from this theorem, one can compute topological entropy by algebraic geometry. And for example, because of the spectral radius is a discrete object, so if F is identity component of automorphism, then topological entropy necessarily zero. So this also explains automorphism of PL, or again, translation of torus has topological entropy zero. And the third part also comes from that this is a spectral radius. And proof I don't end up too much, but most deepest part is lower bound by spectral radius. And this part is most famous by Yomdin. And this is completely Riemannian geometry. And this equality is very important for us, but this is some kind of, this is a linear algebra, but very important, and sometimes we forget the reason, but this is the most important part to conclude this. And this goes back to that F is everywhere defined. And reverse equality is proved by Gromov, and this is complex geometry. And here, idea is compute volume here. Then, number of n epsilon separate points on the iterated graph is just number of point of one epsilon separated point. So if we take ball with radius epsilon divided by 2, then this volume can estimate number of maximal separated point. But the volume here is computed by this, and going back to x, this is more or less same form as appeared in peace dynamical degree. This part is understandable. So, but in our first question is the birational nature. We, even if we are interested in automorphism, but primitive one, we assume vibration is just rational vibration. Sometimes we want to make it to morphism. Then obtained map is no longer automorphism, and just rational map. So to extend notion of rational maps are very important, and many complex dynamic people try to do this. But there are many bad news. First of all, topological entropy can be defined similarly, but slightly delicate. But the worst point is it is no more birational invariant. And also many discrepancies appear in the first Gromov-Yomdin theorem, even in this most simplest birational automorphism. Essential point is this, as a this is identity, but this is four times. So many discrepancies appear, but there is one very good news. This is from by Dini Shimoni's work. So topological entropy is not birational invariant, but somehow estimated from above. This part is quite similar as, but for us, most important part is that dynamical degree, which is analytical number and hard to compute. But it is birational invariant. The definition is formally said, first consider this number, But this part only needs care because this is just the rational one. But we can interpret this part as current, more or less definition by this. Then we can define dynamical degree as a holomorphic case. And here difference is that this is holomorphic case M is always M, but this changed according to M. So this part makes problem delicate and analysis involved. And like this. Before going to dynamical degree, first compare of these two values. Then this can be absolutely estimated is the most essential part. And this part, I don't know any algebraic proof. And they use semi-regularization of current and approximate current analysis by Holmes. And finally, going to cohomological estimation. And this is a topological entropy and dynamical degree. But in order to study every equivariant map, it is very convenient if we have relative version of dynamical degrees. This is defined by Pini and Nui. And that is formally this definition. And this part coming from base and morphism is morphism, so this is form. So this makes sense. And if we take this as one, then this is just dynamical degree of virtual fibers. So this somehow controls vertical directions. And the most fundamental theorem is that the original piece dynamical degree can be computed to these two invariants. Of course, this and this are very difficult to compute for just rational maps. But this equation says that we can somehow consider all situations as if it is a product. And in my starting point, B is assumed to be a smooth and this is morphism. But this does not matter if one takes resolution of similarities and indeterminacy. And then by using this birational invariance of Dinesh Boni, then topological entropy encodes all information encodes here. So this is quite looks quite useful too. And actually, as a corollary, we can obtain this kind of things. For example, dynamical degree is birational invariance, I say, but this is not only birational invariant, but generically finite map it does not change because this part only disappeared, but this is one. And also, lower dimensional cases, if we write down all possible equations, then it is quite easy to get this kind of things. For example, in dimension 2, automorphism is necessarily primitive if entropy is positive. So, in dimension 2 case, all information is encoded by positivity of entropy, and going back to this. And dimension 3 case are slightly complicated, but if F admit equivariant rational maps, then this must be equal. This can be calculated by that product of Euler. So take contraposition, we obtain this kind of things. So we can somehow control by primitive by using dynamical degrees. Now I'm going back to geometry. So from now, more. And first, I start briefly recall surface case. And one of the breakthrough results by Hunter and McMahon is the following. So we are interested in topological entropy and positivity, but it is just the logarithm of the so-called Salem numbers. So and according to Dedichan's observation, surface case exactly interesting one is rational surface, K3 surface, NK surface, and two torus. And in all cases, there are construction of positive entropy, hence primitive automorphism. And also, number theoretical aspect is studied, but I omit this. For example, in K3 surface automorphisms, before our dynamical degree, I observed that the automorphism group tend to be bigger and bigger if we consider family of projective family of K3 surface. And actually, if Picard number 1, then automorphism is almost nothing. But if Picard number is much more possible, then automorphism will become quite complicated and admit positive entropy automorphism. So all maximal rank Picard number K3 surface admit primitive automorphisms. And so, to compare let us introduce this. K3 surface automorphism has a long history, and probably first example is by KD, determinant Kartik. In this case, KD observes there is automorphism of infinite order, and actually this is positive entropy and Picard number 2. So Picard number 2 case already happens interesting things. And most remarkable things, and this is actually my starting motivation was due to McMahon. There is this non-projective case with surface of Picard number 0, the most generic one, but have positive entropy and some very strange domains. And almost always use Fermi's. And rational surface case, there are work by McMillan and Bedford Kim, and they consider explicit equation and make it by automorphism under some periodicity conditions. And they nicely relate to entropy with Hoxeter element in the wide group, which is defined by the orthogonal complement of canonical device, and construct many examples. And in surface case, by rational nature only appears in rational surface case, and there are certainly examples such that never by regularized. This is, for example, observed by, this number is birationally invariant. So if it will be biregular, then this must be Salem number. So we can find, if one can find non-Salem number 1, then it never biregularized. This is Dirac. This is some a very small part of review of surfaces. And we are more interested in the higher dimensional case, dimension greater than or equal to 3. And what we are considering is this problem. And now I already explained this word and this word, and only restriction of biregular is not explained. And one reason is topological entropy has a good meaning. And for me, more interesting part is that in dimension greater than or equal to 3, biregular automorphism tend to be very huge compared with birational automorphism, even minimal case. This is completely different from K3 surface. K3 surface case is the same. So in some sense, finding biregular one is more challenging. And once we find it, then this gives more stronger examples. Because example requirement is stronger and stronger, then more opportunity to apply. So here some tendency. So, first of all, that K-Lin scarcity surface I plotted is an anti-canonical member and Picard number 2, and automorphism of positive entropy, so hence primitive automorphism. So natural, one natural generalization is to consider a smooth anti-canonical member of quantum manifold. Then it is a Calabi-Yau manifold in the strict sense. However, Professor Kolar shows that in dimension is greater than or equal to 3, then automorphism is always finite. So this is completely different from surface case. And the reason is, this is left-shaped, and this kind of thing is also true for K3 surfaces if M is chosen to be generic. But the essential part is amplitude cone is the same, so rational polyhedral. And secondly, if Calabi-Yau manifold, auto-dimensional one, Picard number less than or equal to 2, then automorphism is necessarily finite. But in both cases, there are birational automorphism of positive first dynamical degrees. There are some examples. So this, and a more concrete example is this. I like this example. Let us consider a product of P1 L plus 1 and consider a generic hypersurface of multi degree 2. Then this is again Calabi-Yau manifold of dimension L. And if L is 2, then M is a two-dimensional Calabi-Yau, which is K3 surface. In this case, automorphism is quite rich and positive entropy element. But if L is greater than or equal to 3, then M is a higher dimensional Calabi-Yau. But in that case, under generic assumption, automorphism is just identity. But binational automorphism looks like this. And iota is a natural involution. And the reason is, most important part is that if L is greater than or equal to 3, the covering involution are no longer bilateral, but just birational involution. And this is good news because we have birational automorphism. And more importantly, these are all covered by possible flops. So we can apply fundamental theorem to Professor Kawamata that any birational automorphism can be decomposed into flops and possibly actor automorphism by identification. So we get this kind of thing. And rational surface case situation is worse. For example, following question is completely open. McMahon's example is constructed by blow-up of P2, but it is unknown whether or not one can construct positive entropy bilateral automorphism just by blow-up smooth curves or points. And there are many works in this direction, and notably Bedford can't keep construct automorphism, pseudo-automorphism, which is primitive, this is good, and positive first dynamical degree greater than or equal to 1. So if it is conjugated to automorphism, then topological entropy is positive. This is very nice, but they also show that there are no way to make bilateral. And this example also constructed by linear automorphism, projective linear automorphism, and composite of Cremona transformation with certain periodicity condition of indeterminations. So somehow construct automorphism is non-trivial. And I am trying to construct automorphism means of positive entropy, and actually he's more interested in Bedford questions, but there are several ways to construct manifold. So instead of blow-up construction, we consider percent constructions. Then it is relatively easy to handle automorphism under quotient constructions because quotient by smaller finite group then, and if normalizer is very big, then we have more chance to have nice automorphism. This is clear. But unclear part is what is a quotient manifold by its resolutions? This is very difficult, and I had no experience before to consider this kind of problem. And especially to get rational one is very gambling for me. And we spent a long time, and but never success, but finally some good luck with success. And actual construction we tried is as follows. So, as a target manifold of quotient, we take abelian threefold with high symmetries. And then divided out by a very small group, order 6 and order 3, and take just blow up at singular point. Then we obtain a smooth project of threefold. And it is quite well known that threefold obtained from here is a Calabi-Yau threefold. This is a very famous Calabi-Yau threefold, and I checked then an affine case already known by Calabi, and he considered this. And this is rigid and so on, and many roles. And so this is easy to see what kind of manifold. But as far as I know, this does not appear in any literature. So we try to see whether or not this is rational or not. But this is I cannot say anything about until we get the result. And fortunately, it's like this. And this X6 is actually rational. So we get at least one rational threefold. And second part is more theoretical, I explained by before. Actually, admit primitive biregular automorphism of positive entropy. And I think this is the first example. And the key part of one is for me, I have only two that rationality is determined by the function field, and we consider a function field by using this representation. Then, after some computation, we get to x6 is birational to hypersurface of this form. This is quite symmetric, and if we project this to WG directions, then this is a conic bundle with sections. So this is clearly rational. This is just luck. And actually, more explicitly, later I use, if we take this function, then we can write down function field like this. And primitive automorphism is now easy. Just for example, consider this kind of matrix. Then this is automorphism of this. Then by construction, all descend to the automorphism. But dynamical degree of original one is quite easy to calculate because this is just torus. And we get this. Then, invariance of dynamical degree under generically finite one, we get this. So, numerical criterion says that these two are different, so this is certainly primitive. And from here, this is because biregular automorphism, this is given positivity of topological entropy. This is quite linear. As a map of torus, it is linear, but I'm not quite sure in terms of this coordinate how it looks like. So, for example, translation of elliptic curve looks more complicated than just translations. Oh, sorry. And the trial for X6 is after this example, so after is something. There is a very famous problem that similar quotient, whether or not this is unirational. This was asked by Ueno around this time, and forgot this problem for a long time, but then Campana proved it is rationally connected. And he asked unirational or rational. And I am thrown, tried to this first, but we failed. And so we stick and change to this. But later on, great help of Professor Hakanes, he find more better equations, better representation. Then we finally find X is unirational and somehow satisfied. But finally, he's a real expert of this field and conclude this is rational. So now we have two examples of this. And so finally, I'd like to do some related problems. First problem is related to Bedford original question. And first of all, we already know that two manifolds are rational. So it is in principle to connect by blow up and blow down by weak factorization theorem. And how explicit we can do. And if we are lucky, then this answer second question. And also, explicit description of our automorphism in terms of coordinate, we can find out what is the indeterminacy and so on. So, might give some hint. And surface case, this is quite close surface, but in this case, it is one can check this is cohomologically rational surface cohomologically method, but actually this is obtained by blow up of this triple point of this line configuration. This is due to this. So might be simple, but I don't know. And second problem is that our example is quite isolated, so more examples are better. And I think the Cartier case may be more way to see, but computation of entropy is more harder. And for me, more interesting question is the hyperkera examples. And hyperkera case, we can compute all information of dynamical degree. I'm sorry, I did not yet find a complete example. But if we drop projectivity assumption, then Hilbert scheme of n point of McMurrin's case surface is such examples. So this is hyperkera manifold which admit primitive automorphism of positive entropy. positivity comes from this, but primitivity is very disappointing. We can show that no non-trivial meromorphic vibration from the first. So projective one is more interesting. As an example, but this is kind of fake example. And the final final question is that hyperkera manifold, as explained, one of the basic constructions taking Hilbert scheme of point. But if we start from empty surface and taking Hilbert scheme of point, then it is not simply connected, and double cover is universal cover, and double manifold become not hyperkera manifold, but strict Calabian manifold. And if empty surface is sufficiently generic, then this manifold admit biregular automorphism of positive entropy. And I think this manifold is interesting to study in several views. Quite similar to hyperkera and how similar this is. And in our view, this is an open question, and might give some candidate in higher dimension. This is all, and thank you very much for your kind attention.
Do you have any questions? As you said, your construction using these funny elliptic curves is really very, very special, isolated.
Quotient construction, yes.
But,
yes.
Elliptic curves, for example, elliptic curves with the next case of complex multiplication. Maybe you can do something, or maybe you've tried.
Still this is very isolated, and one problem is that after once we get a result, then we are happy, but otherwise we are very, very exhausted, never reaches, so this is quite risky, and I did not check.
But conversely, maybe there are really very few.
This is a question of Bethoff. And there are no definite answers yet.
In the higher dimensional examples, do you know whether the entropy is taken on H4?
In that hyperkera example,
yes.
That is exactly a middle cohomology. And hyperkera case, automorphism, then entropy is always log of Salem number.
Yeah.
This I prove.
It's log of a Salem number, but is that taken on H4? I mean, not on H2?
Not H2. Middle
cohomology.
Like this.
Okay.
And this is a top.
Okay, thank you.
If there are no more questions, there's one ritual apparently we have to go through, which is to present the speaker.
Thank you very much.